a blue planet on the far side of the universe. It is very special for one reason. Only children live there. They start building on a very small island. Two kids are working on the sandy beach. Their names are James and Elizabeth.
Look, that's a very strange star.
Where?
That's not a star.
It's a space rocket. Look out, it's going to crash.
Space rocket, look at. More like a vacuum cleaner than a spaceship. Suddenly, there's appears a strange-looking room in the robot.
Hello, kids. My name is Mr. Yoli. I can make your sweet dream come true.
See what the great fun you can think of.
With the wonderful.
When I climb the cliffs.
When I watch the sunrise.
When the butterflies fly.
Yoli sprinkled the beautiful dust over the children's hands.
Whoa! They're flying! This is the greatest fun ever.
But now they woodly, but the flow fair of washing the beautiful dust off. Oh, this day stink.
Mr. Yoli hit a solution. They would never need to bat again. He would give them magic stuff made from the rainbow in the sand for a tiny piece of their run. The kids were so happy.
But before too long, everyone became worried. They wanted to fly during the night too. They ran to Mr. Yoli to complain.
How can you help us?
I have a solution. For just a tiny pinch of your jewel at now, I will need the sun to a sky above your island from that moment on. It will always be daytime.
Children on the island loved having Mr. Yoli around. He made life so exciting.
Let's have a race to see who the first there.
During the race, Elizabeth and James played dirty. They began to fall and fall and fall. They landed in a dark forest.
On the other side of the planet, in the other night, to return home and the monks work together. I'm sorry, let's hug at the makeup.
They call them hug because of the magic star.
Look! Oh no! Please, don't eat, Mr. Bear!
I'm not going to eat you. You don't smell like children.
Kids, don't go so quickly. My friends and wild love eat you.
The spider tried to catch James and Elizabeth in her wake. Thanks to the magic sword, they couldn't know the trap. Mr. Spike was so frightened that she ran always.
Elizabeth and James became now as the butterfly monster who could to do anything. The animals would give the gifts to be saved.
I gave you a lamp. I gave you the rising. I gave you potato.
I gave you a gift.
I can tell you yogurt. Ha ha ha.
I can give you all.
As the hyena sitting in the bath was
silence his health, sometimes mysterious.